Ion Entertainment.
EOE.
Ion Entertainment. Keep it an eye, keep it an eye, keep it an eye, keep it an eye on entertainment.
Okay, we're here with Cary Kozlov, and it seems like I've known you forever, even though I just met you, because you're such a good friend of my girlfriend, Joycelyn.
This is true.
So, and yes, and the jet's going over.
I gotta catch that plane.
I think we should start off.
Between flights. That's what I heard.
This is the loudest one ever, though. It feels like it's just like right on top of us.
Like I said, that was the flight I was missing.
Okay.
Right in there. Okay.
Well, you know, yes. What was the name of the thing that I missed? John DeFusco's.
Oh, Waiting for Jack.
Yeah, was it great?
Yeah. I mean, it was crowded, and I got to meet John Densmore from The Doors.
Oh, man.
See what you missed?
Yeah, well, actually, I saw from the pictures, so... Yeah.
Okay,
we're here with Cary Kozlov, and like I said, it feels like I've known you forever because you're such a good friend of my girlfriend, Joycelyn. So tell us, now you're an agent, right?
A literary agent, yes. I represent screenwriters and TV writers, and I go out there and I pitch their scripts and try to get them work in the industry.
Okay, now, did you always know that you were interested in doing that? How did it happen?
God, it's never, a direct line from point A to point B. I think I started representing creative people when I was like 15 years old. I had my own band in Chicago. I grew up in Chicago. And so I was like doing Sweet 16 parties and bar mitzvahs and things like that.
What did you play?
I still do, actually. I play the vibraphone, vibes. Jazz instrument and marimba. I actually started out playing marimba.
Oh, okay.
I was kind of like,
how did you get involved in that though?
I heard a Herb Alpert album years ago. For those kids out there, yeah, Herb Alpert was like really popular in the 1960s. And I heard the marimba in the background and I thought, oh, well, that's interesting. And I found one in my band room in high school and it was all dusty and they said nobody else was playing it. And so I didn't even know how to read music. And I basically pulled out my sister's World Book Encyclopedia and found the musical scales in there, and that's how I learned how to play initially. And then my parents decided, okay, he's serious, after I filled up all these glasses full of water in my mother's kitchen, and I played a song on there, and that's how I got to play that. So, but I was representing our band. I was a manager and all that. How I became a literary agent came much later. I was actually working for a friend of mine now. Vicky Light, and she had a literary agent or a packaging agent, and he just threw a script in my lap one day, and he says, here, take this home,
okay,
and let me know.
Well, was this in Chicago? When did you come to L.A.?
In L.A., that was...
Okay, so when did you come to L.A.?
1978.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so I've been out here 32 years, and I wasn't just doing that. I was also in the comedy nightclub business, and I worked in theaters. I had all kinds of
jobs. No wonder you're so close to Joycelyn. It sounds like you do everything,
actually,
too.
She actually was on stage at one of the clubs I managed, and I didn't know her back then. That was at Igby's Comedy Cabaret in West L.A. So that was from 1984 to 1996. She was taking a comedy class. So I don't know if I was there that night that she was actually on stage. But
okay, so... Why did you come out to Los Angeles from Chicago then? Which of your careers brought you?
Well, I wanted to be a manager or an agent. I wasn't exactly sure what.
Mm-hmm.
So I worked for a number of agents when I was out here.
Okay. And then you got your first screenplay. And then?
Which I hated, by the way. I came to work on that Monday and the agent was looking at me and he was talking on the phone, you know how they do that, talking on the phone, talking to you at the same time. Oh, what'd you think of it? And I go, I didn't like it. And he hangs up the phone and he says, what do you mean you didn't like it? And I thought my career was over with. And he says, that's okay, I didn't like it either, you know. He says, here's another one to read. So that's how that happened. And I was doing like freelance reading, you know, what they call story coverage for a while. And I had an assortment of assignments during that period of time. But I worked for a number of agents, including Robert Littman, who was like a big-time agent in those days. And then I decided I was going to do it on my own because I wanted to represent people I wanted to represent. So that's where we are today.
Okay, and what's the name of your agency?
It's a mouthful. Cary Kozlov Literary Representation. I think I have to shorten it.
Is that the website?
It's actually ckliterary.webs. webs.com.
Okay. Yeah. What are some of the favorite your favorite projects?
Well, right now I'm actually representing some very interesting people. Ann Beats, who was one of the first female writers on Saturday Night Live. She worked there for 5 years and got an Emmy for that. She's also has a writing partner, Eve Brandstein, who was a big-time casting agent for a long time, and so they're like writing, producing partners, and they have a number of projects that we've been going around pitching to HBO and, you know, all over town doing that. And I can't talk about a lot of this stuff because it's like, I also represent Rick Overton, who is mostly known as an actor, but he started out in stand-up comedy. He just finished doing that movie, Dinner for Schmucks. He was had a small part in that. I just started working with Karen Black, the actress. She's also a writer, and so she has a couple of projects I'm working with her on. And Vic Dunlop, who is a stand-up comedian. He's been around for a long time, one of the nicest and funniest people I know in the business. And I have some new people that I like to find new talent. And
how do you find the new talent? Do you have your people?
they usually come to me in swarms. I get like about 3,000 inquiries a year, but I found some of them through recommendation. One of them actually started out as one of my interns, and I soon discovered he was a fantastic writer. And
so who is that?
His name is Sean Camp, and he's a writer-director. He'll be happy that I gave him a plug. Very, very uber-talented, as they would say. And so I figured, well, now he's no longer my intern. Now he's my client. He's my client. But I get lots of inquiries every week, and once in a while I see something that interests me, so I'll read whatever somebody has, and you know, everybody deserves a shot, you know. That's the way I look at it.
Well, yeah. So how many interns do you have?
Well, I had none there for a while. Now I have one young lady that I met up at the Big Bear Lake Film Festival a few weeks ago.
Okay.
And she's very eager and you know, well, she would like me to read her scripts, but in the meanwhile she says, oh, I'd like to do some reading, so she's helping me out. So right now I just have one, but if anybody knows of anybody else that would like to be an intern, please give me a call.
Okay. So are you still in a band?
A band of one.
Okay. You still play by yourself then, right?
If you walk by my house, you'll hear me playing sometimes. Music is a very good therapy for me. I like, sometimes it's just nice to just pick up the mallets and just start pounding out a tune. I haven't played in a band in a long time. Maybe one of these days I'll find somebody that would like to play with me. Anybody like to play with me?
Tyson and I will.
Okay.
Okay. Except that I can't sing or play an instrument. So I know.
Did you play maracas or tambourine?
Yeah, I could do the tambourine, I think.
Okay. We'll call ourselves something, I don't know.
I know Joycelyn.
Where's this going to be shown?
Okay. Now, Joycelyn was it working in your club, but you didn't meet her then, so how did you really meet her?
Oh, well, I was taking a martial arts course. I actually studied with a Shaolin master. And we went to Dragon Fest, which was a martial arts convention, which is no longer, I don't think they have it. And I noticed her from afar. And, you know, I think I was just a lot of young men who, you know, said, ooh, you know, gotta go meet her. But I ran into her a couple of times at those shows. And then I had a chance meeting at a Christmas party. I just happened to run into her again. And I said, oh, this must be divine providence or something. And so we started communicating, and then I lost touch with her for about 3 or 4 years until a couple of years ago. And I just wished her a happy new year, and she got in touch with me, and you know, we've known each other ever since. You know,
yeah, so. I know, and because you're one of her best friends. So, well, I'm glad that I finally got to meet you, and thank you for being on the show.
Thank you.
Ion Entertainment. Ion Entertainment. Keep it an eye, keep it an eye, keep it an eye, keep it an eye on Entertainment.